Welcome back, everyone. November and December, truly the craziest time of the year. But with family and friends around, you, of course, want to enjoy it and not feel so stressed and exhausted. So what should you do and what should you avoid? We have Dr. Mark Hong here to talk a little bit about this, give us some tips, and talk about the kind of role stress plays on our body. Because it makes a huge difference.
It definitely does, Tess. You know, it's, of course, this is the holiday season, and the holiday season, it's actually pretty stressful. You've got family around, extended family, in-laws, a lot of obligations we have that we don't have the rest of the year. And so it can be a pretty stressful time, and that can drag on our energy levels.
Why is that? How does stress play a role in feeling, making us feel down?
Yeah, bottom line is there's a lot of different hormones and different things going on, but the bottom line is stress is going to bring us down. Our energy levels come down, and it's just a vicious cycle.
And along with that stress, what we put into our bodies, we know it's a time of indulgence for a lot during the holiday season. It already began on Thanksgiving. And, you know, there are some good things and some bad things that we incorporate into our lives that can make a difference as well.
Absolutely. It's very tempting when you're being stressed out and things to just, you know, when you feel like your energy levels are low, just grab the first thing that comes to you. So I brought some of the things that we should probably think about avoiding during this holiday season and beyond.
Can we move this just to this side?
Well, you know, everything is in moderation,
okay.
Tess, so this could potentially creep over, but in moderation. But the reason I have this out here is, of course, alcohol. It's one of the biggest things about the holidays.
Sure.
I'm actually not saying don't drink alcohol, but in moderation. No more than 1 to 2 glasses of this stuff. It actually potentially can help your health. We all know it's very difficult to get just 1 or 2, and then that's where you start to really notice a drag on your energy. But some of the stuff that I should note, now this stuff, this has been in the news a lot lately.
Because energy drinks,
the 5-hour energy, and
sure.
Also this stuff, the Monster drinks, these are very popular. We use them all the time to pick up our energy throughout the day. The FDA is now investigating links of possible death, convulsions, seizures, heart attacks from using these compounds.
Specifically by themselves. We've heard about, you know, the mixture with alcohol, but we're talking about themselves.
That is correct. Now, we don't know proof, and we don't know that caused people to have heart attacks. What I will say is if you've got a underlying cardiovascular condition, for example, then you may want to think about stepping away from this stuff. Also, we've got, of course, we all know Snickers satisfies. But the truth is, it doesn't really satisfy you. Now, it will satisfy you temporarily because of the sugar rush. And that's why I actually try to avoid any of these energy bars as well. Because even the more healthy energy bars, they've got a lot of sugar in them. And so it gives you a high temporarily, but it makes you crash later.
Okay.
So we should kind of...
And I have to tell you, I think a lot of people will grab like a Luna bar, a Bounce bar. I don't want to give names out, but they're all the same energy bars. I thought those were healthier.
Exactly. They seem healthier. The wrapping is very healthy.
Yeah.
It's organic. But the truth is, it doesn't actually help us in terms of our hormones, the way that we process sugar, the way that we process the energy molecules that turn us into tired or not tired.
And can make you more tired later on.
Exactly.
Okay,
right.
We know what to avoid. What about things that we should be incorporating?
Exactly. Now, one of the things, of course, I brought along a potato, not because a potato is necessarily that bad, but just to remind ourselves, don't be a couch potato, because it turns out, you know, having a sedentary lifestyle is going to be, on a regular basis, is a huge energy killer.
Okay.
So one of the things we should talk about before even food is get out there, make sure you have a regular routine. And I mean that for not just exercise, but also sleep. It turns out that sleeping, it's going to be the best in terms of not only the amount you sleep, but waking up at a regular time every morning and making sure you have good, what we call sleep hygiene.
Okay.
Some of the other things in terms of exercise, you know, walking is great. You don't have to do anything spectacular. Yoga, I brought my yoga mat because it turns out, well, that's also
moving.
But what it also does, it gets you breathing, and that we know that also helps with your energy levels.
Okay.
Stay hydrated. Got to drink plenty of water. More of this, less of these.
Okay.
And then also in terms of eating, you know, what we eat really impacts how, again, our body breaks down these molecules. And now the best thinking is combining things like whole grains, things with fiber, beans, almonds, these things, combining them with a little bit of protein, such as lean chicken, salmon, those kind of things, they can really boost your energy level naturally. I should mention fiber is an important part that we often think about. You know,
sure.
My buddy's dog, Gus, you know, he tears up the tree when he needs fiber. He knows when he needs fiber. But frankly, we don't. We just don't go through life without listening to our bodies. So it's really important. You know, black beans have a ton of fiber. Brown rice over refined carbohydrates.
Okay.
You know, carbs are not all bad. If you get the whole grain, then actually whole grain carbs with protein, lean protein, that's the best energy booster.
Okay. Dr. Mark Hong, thank you so much for shedding some light on how to help our stress this holiday season. And don't forget, sleep, the most important thing. I have to smile at that because in the news business, you know you have a lack of it. So we appreciate the reminders. Dr. Mark Hong is with Affiliated Urologists in Phoenix, if you'd like more information. Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Happy holidays.
Pleasure. You too.
And we'll get some more sleep.